Okay, I learned the funniest thing about ChatGPT the other day. You gotta hear this. In French, it's pronounced ChatGPT.
Doesn't that sound fancy?
Well, here's the fun part. In French, chat is the word for cat. Je means I have, and pété means farted. So that means every time someone talks about the most popular AI tool in history, they're telling their cat they just farted. Say it with me, ChatGPT. Now, quick disclaimer, I did hear some people say that it's more commonly getting pronounced the English way as chat rather than sha. But why they fixed the cat part and not the fart part, I will never know! All laughs aside, I have got a lot more than fart jokes in store for you today. You know me better than that by now. I'm about to bring you 10, yes, 10, really simple tools that can improve the life of every remote worker and the performance of every distributed team, right now, today. You're watching Out of Office, the bi-weekly web series for remote workers. This is episode 56. I'm your host, Andrew Allen, and today, we are counting down the top 10 GPTs for distributed teams. Now, if I get canceled for this episode, it won't be for the fart jokes. It'll be for saying this. ChatGPT is old news! Yeah, I said it. If your journey with AI tools has been limited to a few conversations with ChatGPT, you're about to get left in the dust. If you're watching this, I'm sure you already know that OpenAI released the GPT Store back in January, which now means anyone and everyone can build their own custom applications on top of the OpenAI framework that powers ChatGPT. The launch did get a fair bit of fanfare, but in my opinion, a lot of people are underestimating the impact that it's gonna have. And if you ask me, that's because of the same principle behind Henry Ford's most famous misattributed quote. If I asked the people what they wanted, they'd have said, faster horses. Put simply, most people just aren't creative enough to grasp the ways in which new technology can enhance their lives. So while it's now entirely possible for you to create your own killer GPT app, most of you probably aren't gonna do that. Lucky for you, lots of other smart people will. And some of their creations are guaranteed to change the way we all live and the way we work forever. It's gonna make a whole bunch of the stuff we all see as normal today as obsolete as one of these was when email came along. And if you don't know what that is, I stan you anyway. Now, without further ado, here are the top 10 GPTs and GPT-based apps that I personally recommend for any remote team. First up, PDF AI. This is probably the simplest tool on the list, and that is exactly why it's so powerful. All you gotta do is upload any PDF, and then you can ask it to do anything you want. For example, I asked it to summarize the key insights from Atlassian's brilliant 40-page report on 1,000 days of their Team Anywhere distributed work model. And it worked a charm. I can't even imagine how useful this would be for time-poor execs who need to digest dozens of long documents every day without missing any of the important details and still have time to actually get shit done. Next, Data Analyst GPT. This one is pretty similar, but for raw data. So just upload your spreadsheet and ask it to summarize trends, create graphs, whatever you need. It's great. Number 8 solves a problem that's gonna be familiar to anyone who's wanted to use Wikipedia or ChatGPT on an important task where accuracy is critical. Consensus finds insights from trustworthy peer-reviewed sources so you can safely cite away without the risk of being undermined by bad data or a hallucination. Next up, if your calendar looks like mine, which is a game of Tetris, you should take a look at Reclaim. It helps you juggle meetings, protect that important deep focus time, and align your schedule with all of your top priorities without the admin. Number 6 is a bit of a hat on a hat, and that is an AI for AI. Anyone working with AI knows that the most critical part is getting the prompt right. So whether you're not quite sure how to make it do what you want or you know perfectly well, but just need it to get there faster, Prompt Perfect is truly awesome. It's seriously impressive how accurately it can extrapolate from a vague direction into a more specific prompt that actually does deliver a better result. Now, as tools get smarter at doing that for themselves, perhaps something like this is gonna become less necessary, but for now, it produces results, and so I highly recommend it. Next, a tool that I've sworn by for years that just had an awesome AI upgrade. Loom is to a Zoom meeting what a voice note is to a phone call. It's perfect for teams that are spread across time zones because it can capture the body language and context clues that don't always come across by email, but it's fully asynchronous. I often find a 10-minute Loom to be more productive than an hour-long meeting, and their new AI features make it even better by summarizing those key points, cutting out the filler words, and even letting people watch at a higher speed. Number four is a big one. There are a lot of knowledge-based tools out there, a lot, but I'm gonna go out on a limb and say Slite is the best one. It intuitively solves a lot of those flaws that you find in tools like Google Docs, from disorganized filing to version control to data silos when information isn't getting shared properly between teams. Its AI features do an impressive job of ensuring that not only does a reliable source of truth exist, but that everyone can find exactly what they need in a snap. Okay, we're almost done. Here's your top three. DailyBot is a tool that automates some of the repetitive tasks of team management. And it does it via instant messenger apps, so it's right there in Slack, Teams, or GChat, whatever you use. Its bread and butter is daily stand-ups, where each team member is prompted to share their updates on current work and progress, and then the team manager receives a summary that highlights any blockers that need immediate attention. It can also do stuff like handling employee onboarding and a bunch of other things like that, that would otherwise require either a lot of repetitive meetings or just not happen. Number two is Taskade. If you ask me, the future of workplace AI is multi-agent systems, where different GPTs can be programmed in much the same way as an organization, with separate team functions and goals, and then let them interact with each other and see what happens. So that means you can create a developer bot that wants to build a really awesome app, a marketing bot that makes sure the product is positioned for success, and then a legal bot that makes sure they don't say anything false or misleading, a finance bot that makes sure they don't go over budget, etc., 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 so it all works together. And last but not least, Personal.ai. There are a few tools that claim to do this, but this one's my favorite. What it does is study how you communicate, and not only recall information to answer questions correctly, but actually to respond exactly how you would. It's uncanny. Eventually, it becomes like the world's most accurate form of predictive texting, or a really top-notch assistant. Now, creating a digital clone out of yourself may sound like something out of Black Mirror or Rick and Morty, and it actually has been a storyline on both of those shows. But while it's natural to be wary of what could happen when this kind of technology gets out of control, you have to admit that it would save a ton of time if you could stay in deep focus mode all day, while knowing that all of those repetitive questions and boring admin tasks were being taken care of by someone who thinks and acts exactly like you would. And that's all we've got time for this week. I would love to hear your thoughts on that top 10 list. Let me know in those comments. I'll be back in 2 weeks with a very special guest, probably the most famous remote work data scientist in the world. Seriously, I cannot wait to introduce you. Until then, I'm Andrew Allen, and the future of work is out of office.